Y'all, my name is B. Williams. First, I'd like to give honor to the Most High, the Father, the Creator of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I stand for the rainbow, under the rainbow. This was the first thing that was given to Noah when he came out the ark. We're going to go to Genesis 9. We're going to start at verse 11. And I will establish my covenant with you. So, what covenant is this, people? What covenant is said that was going to be established with Noah? All right. Neither shall all flesh be cut off any more by the water of a flood. Neither shall there be any more be a flood to destroy the earth. Now we're going to go down to verse 13. I do set my bow in the cloud, and it shall be for a token, an ensign, a sign of a covenant between me and you, me and the earth. All right, it's a covenant. We just read it twice. And it shall come to pass when I bring a cloud over the earth that the bow shall be seen in the cloud. Now, this is the same cloud that led Moses and the children of Israel out of Egypt in the desert for 40 years. This is the wheel inside of the wheel that we will find that's in Ezekiel. This is also known as the glory, as the throne. It is also known, aka, as, I just said it, the glory, Barbellos. And we're going to prove every word of that. We got fake leaders out here teaching all sorts of things and getting you to give away your glory. All right? Your glory, they get you to give it away by calling out false names. Well, we're going to stop them at their false names calling. And we're going to show what the truth is by using the word. If you can't bring it out by the word, by the book, show it by name, I can't hear you. Don't tell me what your translation is. Don't tell me why, how you got it through doing it this way and that way. Show me. If you can't show me and you can't show the people, then you are a liar. And I'm going to show them, and I'm going to expose you and your crew for the slippery serpents y'all are. People, don't give your glory to another. Israel, rise, Zion! Let's get on with this show, people. Let's get on with some truth. Let's suck in some true knowledge. Let's not suck in a lot of lies, a lot of deceit.
None of the elders are giving you this information. Why? They're not telling you where the real Mount Sinai is, and they don't expect you to make it there. But now you have a chance. Praise the Most High. Thank the Most High. They try to stop a woman from speaking, but I'm the only one who can speak. So you better praise the Most High. And they try to use the book against us and tell us not to speak against your brother. If my brother is speaking, is working with Esau to bring down my nation, I'm going to speak against them. I'm going to scream it from the rooftops.
Did you hear that, people? It ain't no more time for peace. This is time for war. I don't care. I'm not here to criticize somebody for saying Yahweh or Elohim. That is your choice. I don't get down with you on that because you have too many different names out here. And if you don't call it by this person's name, but this person qualifies and what this person says, then you are condemned and calling out a false name. They all will say that to you. So I do not call out no names. But does that mean, do I got the right to discriminate against my brothers, against my sisters? This is the lion's den, and I'm coming here, and I'm ready for battle.
Okay. I'm not
going to
allow anybody to stop our people from coming back to Ahia.
Now, she may say Ahia, you may say Yah, you may say Elohim. That's fine with me, as long as you know who your creator is. As long as you put your color codes in, it makes me no difference. Right now, we all must learn. Right now, we all are studying for the truth. I am not here to judge no man, but I am here for the truth. And they are using fake leaders, fake teachers, witchcraft, numerology, imagery, all sorts of things against you. What was the first image the Most High gave his people? Was it not the rainbow, the covenant, the Yod?
So they can kill all that noise. I'm not docile, and I'm not programmed. I'm not dumbed down. I'm very awake, and I thank the Most High for having the Spirit of Christ upon me to speak out. We are in war. There's a time for everything. There's a time to be meek and peaceful and quiet, but it's not that time right now. Judah needs to stand up and rise up and get into the prospective places, in the prospective areas, so that we can start to prepare, so that we as a nation can survive what they have in store for us.
Now, I agree with that all the way. We need to get ready. He said, flee into the wilderness. That's where he tells us to go. Some people have left America all the way around. Some people cannot leave America. Some people don't have the financial. Some people are stuck here because of the laws. It's many different reasons, but their heart is right. Who am I to judge those who don't have the financial means to get out of here? But what I am here for, brothers and sisters, I'm here to go through this with you. I am at the lion's den, and the Most High says, flee to the wilderness. He tells you to take back your glory. I'm talking to you, Nigeria. I'm talking to you, Ethiopia. I'm talking to you, America. I'm talking to you in Japan. I'm talking to you in Italy, I'm talking to you in Britain, I'm talking to you down in Jamaica, I'm talking to all of us. We must rise. We must take back our glory and stop letting these false teachers run away with it.
So please, it's not the time to be docile right now. It's not the time to be not speaking against brothers. If they are speaking against, if they're working against Ahiah and Yeshaya, you have to speak up and you have to stand up. Judah must stand up. It is time for us to rise up as a people and come together for those who are in like mind. If you're straddling the fence, then all I can suggest is that you move out of the way, because there is work that needs to be done. Our people have to survive this. And only the strong is going to survive this. Only those in Christ will survive this. Only those who are studying to show themselves approved to the Most High will not.
Remember, people, the Christ, that Christ is on a cross. That Christ has been tortured. That Christ has been beaten. That Christ has been stabbed. That Christ has, oh Lord, don't let me keep going. This is you, people, Israel, and don't let no other nation try to take it from you. By all means, they want to steal your glory, and your own leaders are willing to sell you out and give your seat to somebody else by calling out different names. Don't give your glory away. Take back your glory. Nigeria, take back your glory. Ethiopia, take back your glory. South Africa, take back your glory. Japan, I know there's brothers and sisters that stuck over there that are true Israelites. Don't give your glory to another. Don't sell out your seat. Let's take off here, people. People, the Most High tells us to prepare ourselves. He tells us there's going to be many places, many mountains from all different nations. There's going to be an end sign for us in the last days, in the last times. We can go into the book of Isaiah, people. And we can go to chapter 4. And we can go to verse 5, and it says, and the Lord will create upon every dwelling place of Mount Zion and upon her assembly a cloud and smoke by day, and a shining of flaming fire by night. For upon all the glory shall be a defense. So what's that glory going to be? What's that defense going to be? Let's just go. Let's go. I'm going to go to Isaiah. Hold on 1 second. I think I just found it. And we're going to go to verse 19. What is that glory? What is that sign that's going to be shown in the last day? We're going to go to Isaiah 66. And we're going to start at 66. We're going to start at verse 18. For I know their works and their thoughts. It shall come that I will gather all nations and tongues, and they shall come and see my glory. And I will set a sign among them, and I will send those that escape of them into the nations. Tarnish, Pool, and Lewd that drew the bow. We're going to go down, skip all the way down in 19, and there's a couple times it says it, but I want to read this one time. And they shall declare my glory among the Gentiles. People, don't give your glory to another. Stop calling out these names. We're going to go to Isaiah. We're going to go to Isaiah 5 and 14. Therefore, hell has enlarged herself and opened her mouth without measure, and their glory and their multitude and their popes, and he that rejoices shall descend in it. Who is the he that shall rejoices? It's the one who thinks he deceives. He one who gives our seats away. The one who sells us out. Let's take out of here, people. I want to go check something else out here. Time for a little break here, and we're going to put some Bob the Hamite on. Bob the Hamite on. We want to hear some of that. Good old. Thank you. All right, people, you heard that. You heard that, people. That was Bob Marley. Some calls him Bob the Hamite. Some calls him all sorts of names. I call him standing for the rainbow. I call him one of our brothers and our sisters. A true warrior. A true prophet. Do I take his word over the prophets we have today? Hell yes. His word has stood. His words has came true. People, don't let others deceive you. Find the rainbow. So let's get on with the get on here. What else we got going on? We want to talk about brothers and sisters that we have that's in Nigeria, that's in Ethiopia, that's back in Africa. We want to talk right now a little bit about Zion! Y'all don't understand.
From deep inside Africa, a sound is emanating that is causing reverberations around the world. It's the sound of Judaism. Centuries of colonialism, returning to what they say are their native roots.
I know from birth I'm a Jew, only I know that my forefather missed the way.
I grew up alongside every other Igbo youth. We kept on hearing that Igbo people came from Israel.
There was a story my mom told me at the age of 6 years, I never forget. She said, Igbos are Jews.
And it's the story of one man, Shmuel, who went searching for what that meant and found answers on the internet, prompting a journey that led him to a community of thousands of Jews. A place where resources are few, but commitment transcends. Through prayer, practice, ritual, diet, and song. But this is also the sound of doubt from Jews in America.
They would ask me, are you from America? I said, no, I'm a Nigerian. They say, you black? I said, yes. They said, no, it's not true.
And rejection from family and friends.
I am like an outcast among them.
And in the...
Now, see, people, I want you all to hear this. Our leaders here in America tell them, since you're from Africa, you're black. Since you're from Africa, you got bones in your nose. You got plates in your ears. This is how our people talk to their brothers and their sisters. This is because our leaders promote this. Promote this racism with inside of ourself. It defiles the holy temple of Jacob, of you, Israel. You are the templar. You are the temple. You are Israel, not no other name. Jesus or any other name they're trying to give out. You're giving your glory to another. When you call out these names, when you call out Jesus, you help out the Europeans, the Gentiles. More of them take power. By different names, it brings different associations. If ones can understand what I mean.
This volatile Christian-Muslim nation, though it often turns to violence.
Our people are being beat, robbed, murdered all over. Villages are coming up missing. This is my people. These are our people. What gives ones the right to judge, to say who is and who ain't? You selfish, prideful. Oh, let me let that ride. Because the Most High. Bring it to the lion's den. Let's put it that way. Talking about my people.
The story of the Igbo. 25 million strong. A people once under siege by their very own government.
Biafra declared its independence.
And a people.
Now remember, this is Nigeria. And the people there are called what? Igbo. Isn't that same thing as Ebola? Hebrew word. Sound. Power. Don't let them deceive us, people!
Once captured and shipped across the Atlantic by the hundreds of thousands. A people who helped build America, and a people whose descendants are now discovering their Igbo roots, raising questions of cultural identity for countless African Americans.
Many African Americans actually do not know that they have Igbo heritage. The chances of their being Igbo is much, much higher than their chances of coming from Ghana or from Western Nigeria.
If you're from the right county in Virginia, you'd probably have a 60% chance of having Igbo ancestry.
It's a story of the strength of belief, ancestry, and community.
My brothers and sisters in Nigeria, I got nothing but love for you. I love all my people all around the world. And I'm not going to give our glory to another. We done did it too many times, Israel. You are the fulfillment. You are that Christ. It's time for you to rise. It's time for you to see. It's time for you to wake up, Israel. Our Father is calling us. We must unite. Nigeria. Listen to me. Zion!
Boosted by a visitor who inspires everyone and helps take Shmuel's dreams to a whole new reality. The Jews of Nigeria are re-emerging.
All right, people. Let's see if I can stop this now. Now, people, now you heard this. We got brothers and sisters in Africa, Nigeria. Come from the Igbo tribe. Ain't we hearing a lot about this word lately? Ebola. And why is our own people talking about our people? Every time they see a dark-skinned person, they call them a Hamite. Or they see somebody that don't fit the category that they believe in, they call them a Hamite. People, it's time to wake up. It's time to stop giving our glory to someone else. Over in Nigeria, I got a video out there where they had our people, in the name of Jesus, going out eating grass. In the name of Jesus. He made the people fast for so many days. And then in the name of Jesus, gave them all the grass they can eat. This is what our people do to ourselves. Our fake leaders and teachers, it's time for them to step down. They done gave your glory away long enough. Israel, you are the fulfillment. It was Jacob that was chosen, not no one else. Stop giving away your glory by calling out all these fake names these leaders give you. Let's take off here. This here is Ethiopia.
Amen. morning in Addis Ababa. The blazing African sun shines on Mount Toto, the highest point in this mountain city, the capital of Ethiopia.
Let's see if it loads up, people. It's stuck for a second. Let's see what happens here. Sometimes that happens.
Ethiopia is a nation as old as the Bible, as new as its first democratic government. Today, it is one of the poorest countries in the world.
Now we're getting a lot of freeze up here, people. I don't know why.
In Addis Ababa, there are a handful of boulevards, hotels, and government buildings, and over 2 million Ethiopians who make up the population. For most, home is a jerry-built shanty on an unpaved rocky hill. In one of the worst of these hovels, the family of Fentahun Assefa wakes up to face another day of hunger, sickness, and unemployment. When they left their village in northwestern Ethiopia 2 years ago for Addis Ababa, their land was taken and their house burned down, leaving them with nothing. Today, they must share their wretched mud dwelling with six other families. Belinish Ezra, Fentahun's wife, is the first to rise from her thin straw mattress on the mud floor. She prepares breakfast for her husband, her sick mother, and four children. With care, for this is ritual as well as food, she grinds a handful of coffee beans and steeps them in water boiled over a tiny fire kindled on the floor of the hovel. When the coffee is ready, everyone will have a cup, and nothing else. There is nothing else. There is only a tiny handful of grain hanging in a sack on the mud wall, and this will be saved for the evening meal. Before the family drinks their coffee, they pause to say a blessing in Hebrew, for these people are Jews. They are the poorest of the poor in Ethiopia, traditionally known as Falashai, a word that means stranger, alien person without land. But of all Ethiopians, they are perhaps the richest in dreams, for they dream of going at last to the land of Israel, a country they regard as their ancient and true homeland. A country where many members of their close-knit family already live and await them. It is not an impossible dream for Fentahun, Belinish, and their family, if only they can survive until it comes true.
The story of the Ethiopian Jews is a fascinating one. There are many stories of their origins. Ethiopian history tells the famous biblical meeting of King Solomon and Ethiopia's Queen of Sheba. According to legend, when the queen returned to her palace in Ethiopia, she bore King Solomon's son, Melanik. When Melanik grew up, she sent him to his father in Jerusalem to learn how to become a great ruler. Eventually, Melanik returned to Ethiopia, accompanied by 1,000 Jews from each of the 12 tribes of Israel to bring the Jewish religion to his people. However, Jewish tradition rejects that, and some tell another story. In the 8th century BCE, the time of the dispersion of the 10 lost tribes of Israel, the tribe of Dan crossed the Red Sea and settled in Ethiopia. There, they converted the pagan natives to Judaism, married with them, and had children, from whom today's Ethiopian Jews descend. This story is the basis of Israel's acceptance of Ethiopian Jews as members of the Jewish people.
In recent years, thousands of Ethiopian Jews have immigrated to Israel. Today, more than 80,000 Ethiopian Jews are Israeli citizens. Fentahun and Belinish's family are part of the last remnant of their people still in Ethiopia. More than 20,000 of them are still waiting, praying, clinging to existence in the hope of following those who have gone before. Gathering in front of their home, a blind mother holds her most prized possession, photographs of her family in Israel. Many others have parents and spouses in the Promised Land. Some have children. Will they survive the journey that will unite them with their loved ones? For a long time, the answer has been in doubt. illness, appalling living conditions, and above all, malnutrition have taken their toll. Many babies are stillborn or damaged. Children are often seriously underweight or too short for their ages. Goiter is common in children and adults. An American Jewish organization, the North American Conference on Ethiopian Jewry, known as NACOJ, and the Lloyd E. Rigler Lawrence E. Deutsch Foundation of Los Angeles are determined to save them. Three programs have been established to feed the hungry Jews in Addis Ababa, and also those in Gondar province.
Now I want you to know one of those names was meant German. It's a German's name. We've been infiltrated by all means. And I know how we've been infiltrated. And I'm telling you, we are giving our glory away. I don't care where we at. We give our glory away. It's time to take back our glory. Now, this goes on for a while, and I don't want to go on any more farther. I just wanted to prove that there, and we want to keep on taking off. Let's get to this cat. Let's see how our leaders talk to our people and talk about our people. Take it back just a tad bit.
If I tried to talk to them, they wouldn't, I mean, well, the ones who were white boys did, but you know what I'm saying, like, for in general. Now, Nick is in there, you know, I'm talking the old extra large 3XXL T-skirt wearing ass nigga, black and mild smoking ass nigga. He would see me, and he wouldn't do the whole, you know, treat me like a light-skinned Negro, but he would clearly be like, you know, this nigga's wearing fucking, you know, clothes that fit and shit, you know, like, I had to go through fucking problems, and I'm not even a fucking light-skinned dude. You know, I'm like glad I'm a nice thing to do because I probably would have been getting fucked with even more. I'm not saying the fuck with like these niggas trying to bully me because, you know, just not.
Hold on. I got to go back a little bit here. I'm catching something here, people. All right, before I go any farther, I want to hear this again. I'm going to leave that alone for right now, though.
Talk with the whole, like, I don't talk all like that, okay? So when I got around, like, girls and shit, you know, they were like, you know, this nigga dresses nice. He's articulate. He don't talk with the old thug, oatmeal mouth, mumble mouth bullshit. You know what I'm saying? So they would be like, you know, Jim's handsome, man. You know, if I tried to talk to him, they wouldn't, I mean, well, the ones who were white boys did, but you know what I'm saying, like, for in general. Now, Nick is in there, you know, I'm talking the old extra large 3XXL T-skirt wearing ass nigga. Black and mild smoking ass nigga, he would see me, and he wouldn't do that.
Now see, first thing, why do you refer to our own, you were a teacher. Why would a teacher refer to another black man as a nigga? Why would a Hebrew teacher refer to another black man in a white man's insult? We have a problem, people. Why would a Hebrew teacher teach against himself? Why would he shame his own people for what glory? Who is he trying to give our seat to? People, when you call out different names, you give away your glory, you give away your seat, your throne, your crown. Plain cut and simple. Let's take off and listen to what he got to say.
The whole, you know, treating like a light-skinned Negro, but he would clearly be like, you know, this nigga's wearing fucking, you know, clothes that fit and shit. You know, like, I had to go through fucking problems. And I'm not even a fucking light-skinned dude. You know, I'm like glad I'm a light-skinned dude because I probably would have been getting fucked with even more. I'm not saying the fuck with like these niggas trying to bully me because, you know, just knock niggas out. But I'm saying, like, you know, you can, like, feel the hate from brothers who are, like, a little darker than me. They would, like, you know, you can feel.
Now, you hear this. First they niggas, then they brothers, then he's going to knock them out. Come on, really? Really? Is that what you was going to do? Huh. Seems kind of funny to me. He seems like one of these cats that got bullied around. One of those nerdy ass, excuse me, one of those nerd cat, you know, kind, you know? One of those ones that, even when he got around his boys, wasn't nothing. Now, I'm not saying I was all this and all that in high school, because I was nerdy myself. But I'm not going to blame my problems on my people. I'm going to look back at myself. I'm going to look back and see what I was wrong at. I'm going to look back and I'm going to just judge everything around me. And maybe I did criticize my people. And I'm sure I did. Because I didn't know no better before I came inside the knowledge of where I'm at today. The wisdom that's been given to me. Israel, take back your glory. Now, if he's talking about this black girl, now we just looked at some other images of people that's in Africa that are Israel. But for this guy, they are called Hamites. He'll sit back and say, No, I never did say all of... You basically did say that. Anybody that does not fit what you call handsome, what you call on your level of understanding. Listen to what he says to this young lady, about this young lady. Now, people, I want you to remember, if this young lady was watching his show, or if this young lady was thinking about becoming a Hebrew, maybe even a Torahite, would she become it now?
You know, but they couldn't say shit like, oh, you know, you're light-skinned because I wasn't. But you could feel that that's, they want, listen, GMS was doing that. They were doing that shit. Oh, nigga, you a mulatto. Nigga, you an East Indian. You light-skinned, nigga, blah, 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 blah. They saw pictures of me. They were like, oh, this nigga's not light-skinned. Now you don't hear shit about none of that.
I say, please go black, dark-skinned man and get with a white woman or get with a light-skinned woman. So that I can come out light-skinned with good hair and beautiful. The child did not, it's not the child's fault. The child doesn't have anything to do with it. So for some of you that will say, oh, don't hate on a kid, no, that, it's not about that. It's about that grown, ill, self-hating individual that cannot love and accept and appreciate his or her dark skin.
Now, nobody is doing this shit but women like this. I don't fucking know anybody that fucking is like so hardcore on this dark skin shit. No, I don't want to play her whole video because it's a bunch of fucking horse shit. But I want to show you something. Look at Rashida, okay? Where's my black pen? Black marker. If I drew dark skin on this chick's mustache area, okay, you'd walk up and be like, Rashida, why do you have dark skin drawn on your lip? Clearly you can see this black marker on her skin. But she's talking, she has 80 plus videos of dark skin. When clearly she cannot go to Africa with this hue and talk about, you know, I'm a Hamite, where's my lip plate? They're gonna fucking laugh her ass off the continent. Now let me show you something.
Now, people, you heard that. You can't go to Africa, Hamite. So he considers every African, everybody that's in Africa, Hamite. He talks about his own sister. He was American in America? I don't know. But look how he talks about his own people. Does this sound like someone that loves themselves? Let me read something to you people. In Isaiah 28:15. Because ye have said, we have made a covenant with death, and with hell are we at agreement. When the overflowing scourge shall pass through it, shall not come unto us. For we have made lies our refuge, and under falsehood we have hid ourselves. This is our leaders, people. This is what they have done. Let me tell you something, show you something else our leaders have done. Let me see if I can find this real fast here. I don't want to go there yet. Leave that one alone. Let's go here. Let me read something to you. Let me take a book that's in the Old Testament here that Judah just keeps bringing up? And I'm going to go to Job 15. And this is for you, Judah, and your crew. And I'm going to go to verse 5. For thy mouth uttereth thine iniquity, and thy choosest the tongue of the crafty. Thine own mouth condemneth thee, and not I. Yea, thine own lips testify against thee. Isn't he testifying against his own people? Every time you turn around, this is what these false leaders do, because they're trying to set themselves up for I am, the great I am. We read about the I am, and we know where that comes from, people. That's the great deceiver. This is the same beast you find in Genesis 4 and 1. Yeah, that's him. Now, this is what the Bible says about our leaders. It would be their own mouth that testify against them. I want to go to Psalms. I think it was 50. And we're going to wait and do that one next. Let's keep going.
Look at Rashi, Judah. Okay. The East African model. Model black girls, short hair, black fashion, blah, 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 black, dark. Wait. Do you see this? Rashida, do you see this? You don't look anything like this, sis. You're not dark enough. Like you have to fucking step down from your position for dark skin advocate president and install her. You gotta go, because you're not dark enough. Okay? Your skin's not dark enough to lead this. You can't be the dark skin person advocate because you're not dark enough. You can't go to her country and fit in. They're gonna laugh you the fuck off the continent. Okay? This is another one. Wait a minute. These are models, by the way. Okay? Models. You know what model means, Rashida? That means they're cute, beautiful. No, wait, hold on. Look how dark her skin is, okay? She's modeling, okay? You lay Bernie Mac.
People, you heard it for yourself. Is it my lips that's condemning him? Is it my actions that condemning him? Is he not talking about his own brothers and sisters? Why did this young man move to Japan in the first place? That's the question we need to ask ourselves. Before we go any farther, I want to take a break. One second here.
Yeah.
We are back, people, and we're about to close this show up. But people, take a good look at our leaders, the ones that say that they love us. And I got another something I wanted to read before we leave here. And before I go there, I want to go to Joel, and I want to show you what this type of leader would do if his time has come. And I'm going to go to Joel, and I'm going to go to chapter number 3, verse number 3. And they have cast lots for my people, and have given a boy for an harlot, and sold a girl for wine, that they may drink. Alright, now we know that certain groups did this to us. Are we going to allow these groups to do it to us again, when we can see their hate for us, even though they look and sound like us? Israel, it's time to wake up. It's time to stop letting them deceive you. They have no good intents towards you, Israel, or me. It says here in Isaiah 5 and 13, therefore my people are gone into captivity because they have no knowledge, and their honorable men are famished, and their multitude dried up with thirst. Our leaders sold us out, people. We're going to go to Psalms to finish this up. Psalms 50, and we're going to start at verse 18. We're going to start at verse 17. No, we're going to start at verse 16. But unto the wicked, the Most High said, what hast thou to do to declare my statute, or that thou shouldest take my covenant in thy mouth? Uh-oh. What is that covenant? We talked about that in the beginning. Is this not you, Israel? Is this not you, Jacob? Zion! Seeing thou hatest instructions, and canst my words behind thee. When thou sawest a thief, then thou consistest with him, and hast been partakers with adulterers. Thou givest thy mouth to evil, and thy tongue frameth deceit. Thou sittest and speakest against thine brother, and slanderest thine own mother's son. This is for you, Judah of Nazareth, and your Torah knights. My name is B. Williams, and I am out of here.